What is up, guys? Wolfhound 22 here, bringing you another Let's Play of No Man's Sky. So a few things have changed since the last time I played. I've got a new ship. I found this on the planet. I think it was Cold Wolf. Still in the same area. But yeah, I was on Cold Wolf here, and I found this one. Slightly bigger inventory. 27 slots. I think my last one had 25 or 26. I've been gathering resources, storing them. I'm trying to get about 500 of each stored up as I go. And I built another warp reactor. Warp reactor Sigma, so we can jump further. This is loaded up. Everything is kind of good to go right now. I want to get a bigger ship so I can start making more additions here. Nothing really else changed here. I know, it's all the same. Same multi-tool. I was able to finally build this beam intensifier Theta. The iridium. It took me forever to find some iridium. So, yeah, we're more or less done here. I want to sort of push forward here instead of going just one galaxy at a time. We've kind of been playing around these first two galaxies, or solar systems, and, I think it's time that we go find that Atlas Pass. I know you gotta make some jumps first to kind of really progress the story, and I think it's time we progress the story a little bit. So, let's go ahead and get up the star map. So I think you need to make a few jumps before the Atlas Pass becomes available. Let's go ahead. Nope. Go ahead and jump to this star system. Engage. Let's go. I'm not really interested in jumping one at a time. I really want to get that Atlas Pass. Like, I think we're at the point now where we've sort of dabbled along. I probably put 30 hours into this game, and I feel that we need to start making some progressions here in the main story. Even once you get to the center, I'm sure there's plenty of time to kind of goof around and explore the planets then. But, you know what, we need the Atlas Pass, we need to get some Atlas Stones, we need to get a bigger ship, a better multi-tool, I need to get more slots. I think I'm up to 31, I didn't show you guys that. Can I look at it? No. So, we need to kind of start finding some things, and at least when I'm recording these videos, that's what I'm going to plan on doing. I'll probably be doing stuff off camera, where I'm maybe exploring some planets, but as far as this kind of stuff, we need to push forward. Alright. So, nothing major here. Where's our monolith at? Hello? On the planet, or is that? Is it on that planet? Yeah, well, we got some time. I don't know if there's another planet over here. I'm not sure what this monolith is. Oh, it's on the planet. I don't know. I can't remember if you have to make jumps first before the Atlas thing comes available. Or if it'll come available once if we have to actually go search stuff first. So we're gonna kind of do this together here. Let's see if this monolith does something for us. We've only made 3 jumps so far, so I'm sure we need to make more. Or 2 jumps, I should say. I wonder why I discovered this. This is so random. It's kind of similar to some of the other planets I've been on. Extreme radioactivity. Oh boy. There's a trophy for surviving on extreme planets. You have to do it apparently consecutively. Holy cow, oh my goodness, oh boy, hold on. Dismantle, can I build a radioactive one? major drop in here. Is this anything other than just a normal non-stand sign on the planet surface does not belong here. The Atlas offers me guidance, purpose, meaning, significance, and an uncaring galaxy. All I must do is follow its path. There we go. I see lines of code, strings of numbers, and a bizarre structure. I feel sure conviction that great power awaits me if I travel to a distant place. The red orb disappears, and I am left with a path to follow. Okay, here we go. This is what we needed. Oh, we got a warp cell. Out of curiosity, what is that? I haven't seen these things. What are you? Callium? What is that? What happened? Let me see here. I want to push it, but I've never found this stuff before. Huh. What kind of it? Whoa. Oh no. No. Don't you attack me. Violent meat eater. It's... You know what? I'm sorry guys, but you guys have gotta go. Cause I need your titanium. Of course I already know it. So you know what, I'm gonna kinda come around here and get some of this. Hold on me. Can I build any more of these? No, I only have the one. Oh, I only got the one done. I'm gonna kinda collect some of this stuff right here. Cause I don't know when I'll find it again. So let me go ahead and get some of this thallium and I'll bring you guys back when I'm leaving. Alright guys, I'm leaving this planet. storm came in, it is just a dangerous planet here. I can't do anything, like, I'm constantly filling up my suit, my radiation protection, I'm going through titanium and, zinc like crazy. Like, man, it's gonna be hard to survive. I think it's gonna survive like 36 days or something on one of these planets. That's gonna be tough. My buddy did it on a planet that had extreme bots, like the sentinels, say, would attack them for basically doing nothing. That seems a little more survivable, so we may look for something like that. But let's see. Okay, so now we have the little... I can't remember how... Okay, Atlas interface. Can I just... Jeez, can I do something here? Seriously. Let's go. Okay. Alright. Engage the warp drive. Let's go. So I know we gotta go through a few of these things before we can find the pass, I believe that was pass, so. So we can find along the way. It hurts me a little bit not to explore planets that we find, but in the same regard, like, there's so many planets, and unfortunately, it's definitely something that I'm learning that a lot of the stuff is very similar. So, I mean, whatever. If we can't book everything, if we can't search everything, then, you know, we can't search anything at that point. I'm gonna get a maxed out ship, which is 48 slots, a maxed out multi-tool, which I believe is 24, and a maxed out suit, which is 48. Okay, so there's this. Hello, giant red glowing ball. I have seen this before on a few people's YouTube, so now you can collect all these little glowing balls. Some of them, most of them, not all of them, I guess, but some of them will give you words. So let's go ahead and just go around and figure all this stuff out. From there. Analyze and upload discoveries, repair, analyze, advisor, analyze other things. Didn't I already do that? Yeah, okay. That's a weird thing to be having. What are you talking about? There's a thing that attacked me. Interesting. Why are you telling me to do all that analyzing stuff now? Making more for restore. I wonder if you'd get more words if you came here without knowing some. Since I already know a lot of words, maybe some of these aren't giving me anything because I already know those words. Let me see if I can get this thing out of the corner here. So we're just gonna go ahead and upload that. Still tell me to upload analyze feature data. Okay. You done? Okay, it's not saying anything else. Good. Alright, so I think all the orbs. I know sometimes there's things you can walk across here that'll give you blueprints. I don't see any. Alright, let's see. So, what do we got here? Warp cell. Warp cell, that's handy. Anything here? Alright, let's check you out. What you got for me? This alien, unlike anything I've ever seen before. I should be afraid, but an inexorable pull draws me towards the heart of the construct. I need to know. This is a remnant of Atlas. It welcomes me. It knows what I am. It offers the promise of true understanding. The intent burns in me. I will peer into the structure of casualty and know this existence. If it is real, or some incalculable vast Samuel Crumb, author of other intelligence, we will accept Milestone and Pathfinder. I will accept this. The sky is deep and full of wonders, and the path of enlightenment opens to me. Woo! Path of enlightenment. So I guess maybe you could come across these things without meaning to. I got the Atlas now. There you are. Apparently these are super, like, they're needed or something for, I'm not sure what they're used for, but I know they're needed. So we'll transfer you back here, and we will put you down out of the way so I do not accidentally save you. That one, and we'll put you there. Alright, let's go. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a couple more jumps around here, and I'll bring you back when I'm ready to get another Atlas, another interface like this, or I find the Atlas pass. Alright guys, so I just jumped one system, and I didn't get a jump right to the next Atlas station. I just jumped one system, because I'm pretty sure if you jump to the Atlas station, it won't have these there. But there's a space anomaly. We're gonna go ahead and check it out. Let's see if this is what the Atlas pass is. Okay, so I can't use my pulse engines. I'm pretty sure this is where you get the Atlas pass. Do I have to go in on the other side? I think so. Oh, nope. I don't. Oh, we opened it up. Yeah, this is Atlas pass territory here. Alright, let's go. can you teach me? This says Polo. Friends everywhere, if only you were to look. Friends in all shapes, all sizes, all places. This shorter entity, a geck, has a jocular air about them. They idly wipe grease splattered hands on their suit as they address me. Some sort of engineer, maybe. To my surprise, they speak my language. Other life forms have treated me with amused indifference, but Polo treats me like equal. They are curious about my travels, about what sentinel species I have seen. Have I met life forms that I have not? They have not. They hope that I will share my experiences. Transmit species data, alien colonists encounter. Yeah, okay, so we're good there. Polo pours over the data, muttering bitterly at the beings that are already familiar with cheering at those that are not. Finally, Polo applauds wildly and hands me a blueprint. Yeah, Atlaspass! Oh, that's great. So let's go ahead over here. Talk to this man. Priest entity. I guess maybe not a man, who knows. Rare linguistic form, pleasure not on divergent corvex. Assistance offered. Route to galactic core. Reconnect with Atlas for guidance. Resources for journey. Yes or no? So we want resources to aid. Find a shortcut to the center or resume the path of Atlas. I think shortcut to the center, right? The alien locates a black hole. Okay, so he found the black hole for us. Is that good? Alright, I know there's something right over here as well. Ooh, that's a pretty cool little multicle there. Is it better than mine? Oh, I don't think it is. Man? No, it's worse than mine. Well, that's frustrating. I was hoping to get a better multicle too. Anything over here? No. Alright. So, we got the Atlaspass, which is fantastic. I wonder if there's a space station here. Let's see if we can mess with some of the Atlaspass stuff. Now, let me look around a little bit and I'll bring you guys back in a minute. Alright guys, so we have the space station. There was one here, pretty close. I know on this side we can... They need a Atlaspass to enter, I believe. Yes, Atlaspass version 1. So we should have everything we need to create one. Yeah. Perfect. Alright, let's get in there. Ooh, looks the same as the other side. So we got carbon. We'll use a little bit of that. More carbon. Oh, and suit upgrade. Okay. Yeah, 32 slots. 190,000. Whew, getting pricey. Is that it? I mean, suit upgrades are cool. I can find a ton of those on Earth, though. It's over here. Is that where I came at? No. V3? Oh, man. Oh, the V3. So, I mean, we got a suit upgrade, that's cool. Just gonna have to look over all over the planet for it. Oh, you're kinda cool. How many slots do you got? How expensive are you? Got 31. Ooh, 6 million. I'm quite a ways away from that. Do you have anything good? I'm trying to find some more of that Omegan, I think it's called. This is buy items. Do you have Omegan? There's not. I still have no clue where to buy that stuff from, honestly. Alright, so now I think we're going to go to the planet, and we're going to find one of those open canisters that always needs the Atlaspass and see what kind of goodies they give you. Alright, I'll be back in a minute. Alright guys, so just a quick little check-in. I am having the hardest time finding those little canisters. I swear I was finding them all the time before, and now I can't find them. I've been on this planet for literally, I don't know, 45 minutes in-game, or not in game, just 45 actual minutes exploring this planet. My ship is super far away. Okay, right there. 21 minutes away. I've discovered almost every species on this planet. All but two. I found more slots for my suit. Collecting like crazy materials. I built some pulse jet upgrades. Like, I'm doing all this stuff. I can't find this canister. I don't understand it. I've been looking for a base so I can call my ship in, because I got pretty far away, and it looks like that'll be a place that I can actually call my ship in, so I don't want to be exploring this long without my ship. It's just I haven't found anywhere to call it in. Found monoliths, learned lots of new words. It's just, man, it's crazy. I don't understand why I can't find those canisters, unless they're just not on this planet. Once I call my ship, and I'll probably go to a new planet and see if I can find it there. Like, all I wanted to do was just do real quick, do one of those canisters, catch it on screen, maybe one or two other things, and then call it an episode. Here I am almost an hour later. Still looking, so I'm gonna keep on looking, and when I find one, I'll bring you guys back. Alright guys, so I haven't found those canisters yet, but I found a facility I had to bust into, and I got a new formula for magmox. I've only found like maybe one of these. I've never seen it in action as far as like what I need it for. But you know, let's get some carbon and see if it's worth anything. Alright, so we'll go ahead and come on back in here. So, transfer you. Nope, wrong. Let's see how much what's this worth for making one of these. 30,000 units for that. So 300 plutonium. I wonder how much that is. So that's 10,000 for 250. Which, so you're looking about two. No. You're looking at less than 2,500 a piece, so maybe you're looking at about 1,200 for 300 of that. Thamium. Again, look, you're looking at maybe another 8,000. And carbon, yeah, you're definitely not looking at much carbon-wise, yeah. So yeah, it's definitely worth buying and selling these things, or making and selling these things. You get 30,000 for that. I wish these things stacked. But yeah, so look, it looks like it would make sense to make these and sell them instead of selling. I mean, you never really have that much plutonium or thamium, but you'll get more money. You get about 12,000 for the 300 plutonium, about 7,000 for the thamium, and about 1,000 for the carbon. So that's going to be about 20,000. So it's about an extra 10 grand to sell those. That's pretty good, actually. So keep an eye out for that stuff. Get everything else here. Alright, well, I called my ship in. There's still not any of those cases over here for whatever stupid reason. I don't understand. So what I'm probably going to do is just fly off to another planet, and maybe this planet just doesn't have them for whatever reason. You guys, I know you guys. But I also found a way to get these birds a lot easier than I was. I just shoot them. And whenever they die and land on the ground, then I can catalog them, and they're so much easier. So, alright, let's go get out of this planet. It's been alright, decent planet for me, but man, I'm really frustrated I haven't been able to find those little canisters. I've seen them everywhere. Whenever I was on my other planets, when I didn't have my Atlas Pass. So let's see. Should we go to that one? I wonder if this is any better. It's like a two upgrades to my pulse engine. Now see, it still seems like you go the same speed. 9,999. This just means I'm better on gas. I mean, provides increased maneuverability, longer boost, first thamium consumption. Seems like these are the same thing. You know, I see that I have that great maneuverability. I don't know. I built them. Anything I could think is just gonna let me not have to use as much stamium. Alright. We'll go ahead and land on this first spot. If I don't find one, then I'll just have to mess around until I do find one, and I'll bring you guys back. So, let's see what we can find here. Well, this is a pretty barren planet. Oh, wait, let me get closer. I see gold. That's cool. Mine that. That's barren. I'm gonna guess there's not gonna be many animals. Which isn't a big deal, I don't really care. Sorry, sorry. Alright, let me see what I can find. Somewhere, copper. I mean, I'm gonna have to stop here real quick. Oh, this is gonna be a decent planet for resource gathering. Okay, let me go ahead and grab. The weather's fine, sentinel's typical floor, none, fauna of the void. Okay, so there's just really not a whole lot here. I'm gonna guess no animals, right? Usually, oh, I see some canisters over there. Oh, yeah, nothing. Okay. As you can see, I'm getting kind of low on cash. It's going to bring me way down. But I got 32 slots. So, yeah, here we go. Atlaspass. Let's see, what do you give me? Probably nothing. Ooh, electron vapor. Suspension fluid, so it gives you slightly better materials. Which is cool, because those sell for 4,000 and 1,100, so nothing crazy. But, I mean, they still sell. So, yeah, this video I've been recording for way, way, way longer than I really intended to. So, I may just go ahead, I think I'm just going to go ahead and call it here. I think what I'm going to end up doing, since I'm getting kind of low on cash, is I'm probably farming this planet for a little bit. Just in the brief, what are you? What are you? Hey, hold on. Let's get this first. Are you gonna attack me? Gravitino ball, alright. I got a Gravitino ball. What is that? Oh no, 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 no. Oh no, oh no, what happened? Holy moly, why did I do that? Why did I attack? Why? Oh geez, hold on. Alright, let me see, where's that sentinel? Interesting. Alright, you know what? I am afraid of you. We're going rounds here, boy. Yeah, what about that? Not dead? Oh no. This is gonna end very well for old Wolfman. Okay, you're dying, you're dying, you're dying, you're dying, you're dying. Oh no, whew. Oh man, I wasn't even paying attention to that. Ooh, wow. That was pretty intense. I don't want you. Can I transfer you? Can I transfer you? Go ahead and do this. Go ahead and do this. So also, what I've figured out is once you've built the Atlaspass, it doesn't go away, which is super awesome. No, man, I'm getting like absolutely nothing. There we go, the initial matrix. So yeah, you get pretty much nothing anymore when it comes to, what are you? You're one of those robot dogs. Yeah, so, Whenever, lately, like every blueprint I get, I very rarely find one that I haven't already used. This is frustrating. I like to find some new things every once in a while. This is crazy. This is the first time I found any of these plants. And they're like super not cool with me taking their stuff. You're cool. Are you still here? As soon as I do this, it's gonna give me 3 stars. Interesting. Well, that's kind of cool. I mean, how much do those Gravitino balls sell for? 27,000 a piece. Oh man, I wonder if there's a lot of them on this planet. Okay, well, regardless, that's gonna do it for me on this episode. I'm gonna farm this planet like crazy. I'm going to maybe work on my suit a little bit. I got a lot of suit slots now. I think I need to maybe look at building possibly some shielding. Yeah, I need to build a couple. I can build this one. I can build that one. Can I build another one? What's this one need? Oh, yeah. Heck yeah, I can build that. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. And then I'm also gonna come in here like this. What do I need here? Yeah. I'm really built up now. These Gravitino balls are excellent. I'm curious, before I go ahead and end this episode, you guys, let's go. You know what? I didn't even. Did I get my. Yeah, I did get my suit. Let me see how good this thing is. Okay, where are we at? Where are we at? Where are we at? Alright, come here, you. Oh man, I can't see anything. Oh wow, these things are everywhere. Look at you. I'll take you. Take you. Gold. Wow. Okay, yeah, wow. So, got a little distracted there. I don't think it's deactivated. It definitely seems like there's a lot of stuff around here. So, yeah, I'm harvesting this planet, like, for a while. So, yeah, that's gonna do it for this episode. I'm gonna spend a bunch of hours probably harvesting and racking up a lot of loot here, if I can find a trade post on this planet. But yeah, if you enjoyed the episode, hit that like button. Subscribe if you oh, stay no. Subscribe if you haven't already. Share with your friends. Leave a comment. Let me know what you like if you would like to see anything in particular. And if you leave comments, you know I can maybe start naming. Because I'm kind of running out of ideas for animals or plant life or well, I don't know the name plant life or planets or systems. So you leave a comment and give me some suggestions or even your username and maybe I can start naming some things after and people will leave me comments. So, but until next time, this is Wolfhound22 signing out. Barrel roll, yeah.